Hello, friends. Welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved. So I have been a rather busy guy. Freaking plants were going in the house again. Before I forget about it, look. They've fixed the paint, or they've changed the paint, so it now affects the entire surface. So now I'm much happier about actually painting things, at least surfaces. Before it was not good. So before I go out there, so when we left off, we were taming some more pets, and then I spent the last few days. I got my pterodon saddle, or pteranodon saddle, and I flew around the island, and I basically put down beds in little cabins all around the island. The reason I want to do that is because it has come to my attention that I have outgrown this little peninsula with the number of pets that I seem to be acquiring. So let me take you on a little tour. So we've got Crimson Cloud here. He's my level 31 Tyrannodon. He's my fly me around, take care of these. This is Moss Glider. Now, there is another Pteranodon somewhere out in the world. I don't know if he's dead or not. His name was Copper Skies. And he disappeared while I was taming some raptors at one of the cabins. And I don't know where he went off to. So, here's Skyfire. Let's go ahead and... Stamina is pretty much all I'm doing with these guys. So you can kind of see what I'm doing. I have storage boxes, simple beds. I haul some stuff with me. I take some other stuff. I have it there when I get there. But basically, I've flown around the island. And unfortunately, I did not leave. And again, once again, the pins you see are actually from my co-op server. And for some reason, they are not showing... I mean, they show between... your sessions. So I did not put GPS coordinates down for the beds, but I've labeled them all so I know where they are, and they were kind of scattered all around. So what we're going to do in a few moments is look at the actual beds and take a look. Dang, I wish it would be a little quieter. Alright, so we've got raptors now. Oh boy, we have raptors. So we've got Apple, original Apple. And I haven't been here, which is why they haven't really leveled up that much. So I've got Flame, Trace. Firestreak is one of my new ones. I captured him just recently. He was a nice high level, and I got food in him really quickly. And I think I got like a bonus of 15 level or something like that. So that was excellent. Sprinter. And I've got Gentle Fang. Gentle Fang was the mate of... Firestreak, and I lucked out. Crimson Fury. No, hold on. Gentle Fang and Crimson Fury came as a pair. Yes. And we've got Grayto over here, and Larry. You can't forget Larry. So what else do I have? A Mo and Curly, the originals. And Silvertip, who was my primary mount, and now Firestreak is my primary mount because, you know, level 69, indeed. Now I've got to make a few more saddles. Saddles are armor, so, and they're pretty cheap cheap-ish for these guys. It's just some hide, and I get hide like mad. So I need like three more saddles. No, five more saddles. Yep. All right. So, Rustolium is leveling up slowly again. If I was here, I moved her over to here because she was so far away that she wasn't getting any leveling benefit. So now that she's parked right next to us, she can level up a little bit. And we remember Nina. Nina's looking good. She's up to level 16. I started taming another Spinosaur and get killed on me. I seem to be cursed with the Spinosaurus, but we'll hopefully sooner or later we will get the Pinta and the Santa Maria. And of course, we've got Salmon Belly and Karna, the mated pair. I'll get your face out of my face. And they're leveling up pretty well. He's starting to, you know, level up quickly, so that's good. And then we've got Bruce. Brucey, Brucey, Bruce. Hello. Holy crap, the head's huge. Yeah. Smack. You behave. So Bruce is awesome. I'm looking forward to the day when I can make the saddle for him. Oh, really? You almost crushed me, you ass hat. All right. What else do we have here in the compound? We still have Trickster and Mrs. Tracy, our cop, and we've got... We've got... What should we call him? We're going to call him Purple Nose. He doesn't get a dignified name. Alright, What else? Of course, Sir Carbs a lot. And Cankles. Oh, Cankles leveled up. Speed. These things are slower than freaking hell. And, Icky and Squishit are about level one. And then the whole Dodo gang, or Dilo gang. How many do I have? These things are so freaking easy to tame. So you just have like a pile of them. And I'm not sure what I'm going to do with them. But I think I'll take them with me when I go to the cave. And that way, they're just, yeah, they'll just basically be damage magnets. You? I really, the more pets I get, the more I'm wanting them to add some sort of a pet management tool, like a tribe manager. Just list all your pets. You can see what level they're at. If they need to be leveled, you could apply a level to them. You could name them. You could change their settings. But you couldn't affect their inventories. You couldn't feed them or anything like that. But otherwise, I think it would be good. And then, yep, Lady Stella and Poincar. So that is the family, and it is growing. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I have 12 raptors. Holy hell. I have a bit of a problem. I am addicted to taming now, it seems like. Are they still going? It's amazing, the spark powder keeps stuff good forever. Okay, so what I'm going to do is dump most of my... Oh, I got some more. So I got the refining forge, you don't already have it. I have metal sign, trike saddle, compass. I might as well put these berries in the fridge. Azul berries. Oops, I have narcos in that one. I have narcos left in this one. I got room for them. They'll be gone before I get back here anyway. Let me dump. So, because what's going to happen is I'm going to fast travel, and then that will. I think. Let's see. Oh, I got those arrows out of that box. Is there room in here for them? Negatory. I'm starting to do really well on supplies. Alright, I'm going to store all of this stuff in here, and you're about to see why. I have never fast traveled before, so this is going to be a new experience. Basically, you're supposed to drop everything you have gets dropped, so I'm assuming I carry parachutes because I was, you know, in case my mount falls asleep on me. Yes, transfer all. Oh, I can't put those over? Maybe they won't drop. All right, so if we go to our bed, did I ever name this one? Happy place. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna fast travel. So here's all my beds. The only kind of landmass I don't have a bed on is this area. Just because I didn't. So what I want to do is show you all of. Okay, that's the bed. That's my one of my original beds. Southwest 6419. Okay, so I want to get your guys' feedback on which house. So each of these houses is going to be identical. I set them up almost identical. So inside, I've got a bed, campfire, a little bit of supplies that I had. Oh, this one actually had a set of armor and stuff too. I had a supply chest and that had a nice full set. And this one I think is empty. Yeah, this one is empty in all of them, I believe, and I just shoved everything in that box. So basically, hopefully I don't get killed. Well, if I get killed, it's not a huge deal. So this is one potential base location. Now this one was a little funky. This is where I got the three new raptors, and also where I lost Copper Skies. Like I said, I never got a message that Copper Skies had died, but it just he just disappeared. And he was a high level too, so I'm a little annoyed. I had to make a new saddle, which, you know, is not a big deal, but that one uses keratin, so that was a little bit expensive. So anyway, this is the view from this one. I did get a Carno as well. Lots of par. Okay, Parasaur. Banasaurus. Okay, so anyway, yes, this is the view up here. And if you look on the map, we can kind of see where we're at there. So we're kind of right in the middle of that bottom left-hand chunk of land. So if we build up here, I would build the house probably centrally located. And then, yeah, or maybe on this side so it has a view of the lake, cut down the trees out there in front. Oh, look, Copper is here. What were you doing over there, buddy? Okay, I don't have. Okay, Copper Skies kick his ass. Oh God! Now don't get killed, you freaking idiot. I don't have any. I didn't get the. I have a bow. Oh great, you freaking brought him right to me. This is not good. A level 60. And a level 42. Copper Skies, I don't like you right now. All right, well, I can't respond there right now. Or maybe I can. Well, let me wait a few moments. So let's respond at this bed. Come on. Why can't I spawn there? Oh, maybe this is the other bed. Okay, so 6015, I roughly targeted where they were, that lawn. So that's that one right there. Let's go ahead and spawn at that bed there. We'll wait a few minutes, then we'll respawn back to the other bed. Okay. Now this one seemed like a very a tamer area to live in. I didn't get attacked by anything while I was here. It was quiet, it was peaceful, and the views are spectacular. It's a little out of the way, but I could see building, you know, right up here on the edge, with gorgeous views. So again, if you look at the map, this is where we're at on that little peninsula right there. It's funny, it's right next to the, it's kind of near a hide, my little hideaway, which I think is actually over just right there where that Trinaut is flying. That's where the hideaway is on. Oh shit! Remember how I said I hadn't been attacked by anything there? Alright, well, that's that bed. Okay, this is why I need, I need more gear in those buckets. I can totally gear up. I've died more just showing you guys the houses than I have in a long time. Alright, so let's go up here. Now, the benefit of this one is there is good access to a lot of high level. Pardon me. Sorry about that. Didn't mean to yawn at your guys' ears. Access to a lot of high level stuff. So let's go ahead and click here. There's actually a cave right about here. This is mammal area. So we've got mammoths, cats, eagles, all that kind of good stuff. So it's also going to be a little bit more dangerous out here. The scorpions. There was a lot of stuff going on, but this view is pretty good too. So this is nice big savanna, African raptor. We'd be killed by another raptor. So anyway, you can see there's the one of the big volcanoes up there. Right over there in that little saddle is where where one of the caves is, and there's another big hill up there, which we can use for getting. We can get lots of materials here. This would be a good spot for metal and everything else. I'm not sure. I mean, there's a lot of animals, so it would require a little bit of work to keep things safe. I definitely put a wall up and fence everybody in. But I could just see putting a big pen down there for all the dinosaurs, which would be kind of cool. It does get cold up here as well, so there is that. Ha! You didn't kill me this time. Alright, so let's go ahead and travel to the next bed. We'll travel this one here in the center. I can't remember what the big deal with this one. This is one of the first ones. I think this is the first one I put together. Look outside before I go out. Yes, this is the first one. So, beautiful views. It's a slope, so it's a little bit tougher to build on, even though I might be able to build on that little area over there. In fact, I had to build with pillars here. So that was the first time I've had to build with pillars. But it looks pretty cool. The view-wise, it's a gorgeous view. And it's fairly centrally located. You can see where we're at there, basically at just about 60-40, just about. So it gives decent access to everything. Alright, so let's hop back in, go to the next spot. This is kind of nice, I like going through this. We'll go up here to this one. I think this one was a nice, quiet spawn area as well. So this is more of an interior spot, but I figured you could probably do something with this whole little, little valley area. I don't remember or don't recall seeing anything bad here. Well, bad being, I'm gonna have freaking T-Rex with me, so. And what, a dozen? I said, dozen raptors. So I'm not too worried about a little bit of bad here and there. All right, so anyway, let me show you guys on the map where this is again. So we're in the upper right-hand corner. Gives us access to just a different amount of stuff. And when I was looking for spots, I was kind of looking for open areas that had a decent amount of flat terrain to go with them. That was kind of my rationale. Okay. And over to this one. I keep waiting to spawn in and have like a freaking T-Rex eating the house. Alright, now this one is a cool little area. Nice, big, flat, open area for building on. It would be almost epic for that. The views are, I mean, they're nice. There's one of the pillars or obelisks over there. And up, I believe it was, yeah. Really cool cliff face right there to look at. And I think there's mining in Dam Bay Rocks. And I think, so you can see this is a pretty nice open area. I'll take his dino, as long as it's low level. So you can see that's kind of cool. So I was thinking even of building a house up here with the pens and everything kind of down in that area for all dinosaurs. Nice uplifted rock. So that could be kind of cool as well. Now what I'm going to do in post-production is I will put numbers to each of these spots, and what I want to do is I'm actually going to let the video bake for a couple days, let you guys take a look at it, and I'll do something else. Give me going on a little bit of adventure as well. I keep going on adventures, and then I want you guys to vote and tell me your guys' preference for where you think I should build. Oh, I didn't even close the door on that one. Oh, this is one of my... Okay, this is one of the original ones that I built. I think I built this one. Yeah, I built this one on camera with you guys. So this one's very central. Got some cool views. Not as much flat ground, but it would work. We could even do a pen or something down below with maybe a ramp or stairs going down, which could be kind of neat. So that's that one. And so we got that. We're there. Let's hop down to this one. Before I buy, I'm always like, okay, is it safe to go outside? Okay, now this one's built on a peninsula, or not a peninsula. The river's split to both sides. So it's a really cool view right there. I mean, that's just really neat. Pretty easy to bring water up here. Not easy. It's going to take a long frickin' time. Yeah, it's gonna take a long time. But it could be kind of cool to do it. Pretty decent amount of space once you take these rocks out of here. So that's a nice possibility. And let me show you guys where that is on the map. Me. So I'm over there in the top of that little piece of land. Okay, there's only a couple more of these. Oh, this is the cave. Alright, this is just the cave. Cave is set up a little better, obviously. Alright. Cave is that. So that's the cave. Uh, Wait, oops. Cancel. Let me make sure I label this bed. Cave bed. Okay. So where is this one? Oh, this is one of those little shacks I built while I was taming. Okay. Well, at least they're, you know, at least they're fast travel spots. Outpost, happy place bed. Okay, let's go back and see if my bird, my Tyrannodon, survived that encounter. Oh, we're still fighting them. Okay, let's grab arrows and a bow. Oh, let's grab his armor too. Why not as well, right? That'll help. I wish I had Trank stuff here, but I do not, so. The bird is so freaking fast. The raptor's like, what are you doing? Oh, now he's gonna get his ass kicked. Of course, he's a level 60, so it might. Good job, guys. Good job. All right, let me put this stuff back in here so that I've got it when I come visit it. Ah, too bad. Man, I wish I had all my stuff here with me, because a level 60, by the time I got, you know, if I got him fast enough, I bet that would have been like level 80. Sweetness, I'm so glad you survived. I'm so glad you survived. Let's grab this supply crate real fast. I'm naked on a Pteranodon. Oh, frick. Okay, don't go anywhere. Metallic door. Sweet! Oh, wow, look at that view. Alright, so I'm gonna head home. And like I said, basically, what I want you guys to do is weigh in. Let me know what you guys thought of the different spots. That's weird over there. Oh, can I make it to that one? Don't push it. Don't push it so hard. Oh, this is lag. Ah. For some reason, this one spot, there's always so many dinosaurs spawning. Now, I have increased the dinosaur spawn count in my world. I went ahead and reduced my level of my XP gains. It was getting a little too much. And I looked at my resource collection. I'm only at like 1.2 or something like that. So I think either they improved it slightly, or those metal tools are just that much better. Because I am gathering stuff so well. Even though I don't do I try not to do very much by look at all the Rexes and everything going on. Alright, let's sprint some more. I can probably make it on a sprint. I think I've got some narcoberry, or some stim elents. You can make it. You're almost there. I love these blue ones. Blue ones are always, I'm getting all kinds of freaking really nice blueprints off these lately. Save me the points. Alright. What do we get? They gave me two blueprints for water jars. I hate being naked. Clappers, guys, will you get down here, please? Would you please get down here? Where'd you go? Alright, where's that little beast? Alright, anywho. Lighter, brighter. It's so much nicer to fly around. I cannot hardly wait till I get my Argentivuses. But at least you can get the Toronto. So yes, in case you guys didn't notice, I am level 41. Very, very nearly level 42. I have unlocked the guns as well. So I think what I'm going to do very closely coming up here is I'm going to go ahead and make the guns. We'll do that on camera. That'd be kind of fun. In fact, we may not be able to have all... We'll have to find out if we have all the stuff. And then I'm going to the next few episodes. I'd like to tame a megalodon. We're going to need to get pearls pretty soon to get polymer and oil, pearls and oil pretty soon for stuff. So that is going to be kind of my next big thing. Let me get in here and get my stuff back on. I want to do one little surprise for you guys before I end the episode, and that is, it is the 4th of July! Woohoo! Woohoo! Happy 4th of July to all the United States folks out there, to all the rest of you guys, happy 5th of July! Yay! Fireworks, so pretty. Woo-hoo. That's cool. It's awesome. Ooh, ooh. All right, friends, thanks a lot for watching. If you like it, remember, click that like button, comment, subscribe, tell your friends, family, and your grandma. Enjoy your 4th of July. Don't say anything on fire that I wouldn't. I'll talk to you later. Bye.